Okay, so today we're going to put on a set of these well visors, window blinkers. So I want to get a set of these for a while. So we're getting the kit.
There's also the four deflectors.
These are the front ones. For the back. There we go. Got a couple of cloths to clean up the area where you're going to stick them on, and these are the fittings. First thing we need to do is take down the windows. It says the first thing you need to do is to open up this packet of wipes and clean the area where the sun visors are going to be attached to. They only give you two, so it makes sense to clean, to do it one side at a time. So now that I've cleaned this, I'm just going to get it right over. Just to make sure it's dry. I mean, this type of stuff evaporates off pretty fast. Unfortunately, the car's fairly clean because it's only been a week since I washed it. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do with the visor here is it has these mounting holes. There's actually two of them on these front ones. Seeing as we have eight clips, I'm going to get two on the back too. I'm just going to hold this up to the side of the car to get some idea of where they need to be. We're going to put one. I'm going to line this up basically up with the back of the door. It's not exactly the same length, there's a little bit of a gap here at the front. So we're going to have one about here, and the other one a couple of inches in, just about there. You take the clip, and you also got to make sure that the ring is facing outwards, because you're going to have to put your one in here, and it basically goes between the weather strip, so the rubber and door, and the door. One goes about there, and the other one goes about here. So we'll pop those in. Obviously, they can slide around from that position, so good idea to position these now before you put it on, at least roughly. And it'll also give you some idea where it needs to be. And that's basically how it's going to sit. So. Now we have to take this back of the protective sheet off because it's right where we need to be. I'm just going to take this off now. Okay, so you can see what we're working with. There's also a second layer of protection on this here. We'll take that off afterwards. So what they say you should do is peel off this red, yeah. See, I'm being very careful not to accidentally peel off the whole thing. Here we go. So they say you should peel off this first piece. And as you can see here, this is 3M branded stuff, so it should stick really well. And then once this is all peeled off, it should be good to go. Now they say just peel off a couple of inches to start your kit going, as well as the yellow tape at your end. And I guess the initial placement is probably the toughest part. And then they say you should just gradually take your time and put pressure on it, then peel a bit more tape off and put a bit more pressure off and peel off a little more tape. I don't want to stick it down in the wrong spot. I'm actually going to use the clips as a guide to the height of where it needs to be. Let's go slightly off. Okay. And I'm going to use this other clip as a guide for this end. And then apparently what you do, you just peel this up a little bit so you can grab hold of it. Yeah, so you use line up the holes with the clips, and then you'll know you've got that position about right, because otherwise you're not going to be able to get the little locking that's in. There we go, and we're just going to put some pressure on that. There we go, and that's on. You can imagine how it's going to be. Now we'll just go to the grab hold of this as close as you can to the visor and just peel it back and apply some pressure and peel it back a bit more. Obviously don't be too heavy handed with that tape, because if you snap it you're going to be in all kinds of problems. It may even be a good idea just to put a little bit of pressure from behind so you can lift the tape away. But yeah, basically, so you press down the bit you've done, get your fingers behind it so you've got a bit of room, and then you just work your way along. And then before you know it, down the other end. I think with this tape as well, there's a certain amount of stretching it, so if you feel it stretching, you know you're pulling it from too far away. There should be quite a bit of a benefit to fitting these things. The main idea is you can have your windows down a bit when you're driving, and you get that breeze coming in. You won't have to use much air conditioning, because the problem you get once you get to about 35 miles an hour, you get too much wind noise, too much air in your face, so you can't really have the windows open. The downside to these guys is, because they are stuck on, that you're basically, once they're on, you're on. You can't move it to a different car, like, you know, an ST one day. You know, that's what you're into. So here we are, just about finished on this first slide, and so you get the idea. I found with these clips, the best trick is to take the centre part, stick it through the hole, then put the ring on the back, and then put this pin in the front. Now as you're putting it in, I find if you just give it a twist, it starts to go in there and just pop in. And once it's in there pretty securely. Then once you've got that all in there, all you've got to do is remove this last piece of plastic, which is really good to have on there while you're pushing it down. Because you're putting a fair amount of force on there, and covering your grubby fingerprints. Same on the front. And that is the white nose. I think that is a functional mod that isn't too expensive, that anybody can do. And you know, every time you look back at your car, you see that one, and you know you're driving a car that's modified to some extent or the other. That feels good.
I'll just show you this close up. Here we go. Here we go. There's the visor here in position, and there's the other one. I reckon that looks a business. So there you go. Thanks for watching. I'll put up more content when I've got more stuff for the car, and I'll see you again soon.